the presidential debate, or what passes for one on my show. Republican presidential candidate Herman Cain is here to debate this man. An imitation President Obama. He's an actor, but what he says tonight will be entirely the president's own words. And if you don't believe that, you can go to johnstossel.com. We've posted the video of the real President Obama. First question for the candidates. The deficit. Should we freeze spending? We're in real trouble, Mr. Obama.
Well, the problem with a spending freeze is that you're using a hatchet where you need a scalpel. Now, there are some programs that are very important that are underfunded.
He wants to use a scalpel. Programs are underfunded.
I would rather use some common sense and increase the growth of the economy and do targeted drill downs to find where we need to cut in a responsible way.
What would you cut? Give me a couple examples.
For example, we are subsidizing Amtrak. Amtrak, to me, is another business that ought to be able to stand on its own without any help from the federal government.
One more example.
How about Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac? Yeah. We are subsidizing two entities that led to the financial meltdown. They need to be privatized.
That's big money. That's $100 billion bucks they've
got. Exactly. So let's go to the big areas where we can restructure and not have to raise the debt.
What should we do about the debt limit? Should we allow government to spend more money?
Well, if it defaults, then the consequences for the U.S. economy will be significant and unpredictable.
Well, if I were president, I would not have allowed it to become a crisis in the first place.
All right, well, it's a crisis now.
It's a crisis now. So here's what we do. First of all, we will not default on the debt because the amount of interest that we pay is approximately $500 billion a year. That is about 20 times smaller than the amount of revenue we bring in. So what I would do is get away from the scare tactics because, you know, throwing grandmama off the bridge is just a scare tactic. Make sure we pay the military people and the military families, make sure we pay the interest on the debt, pay the Medicare bills, and then make sure that we pay the Medicaid bills. And guess what? Everything else should be on the table and get serious about cutting the debt.
And we have $2.6 trillion in revenue. We can pay for that without increasing the debt limit.
Exactly. So,
well, we will raise the debt limit. We always have. And we will do it again.
And therein lies the problem. They always have, and they always will, if we don't stop it. And now is the time to stop it and not do it and make those tough choices.
Right. Health care. Your Obamacare, I'm sorry to use that term, but big success?
Well, in the United States, no one should go broke because they get sick.
In the United States, no one does go broke because they get sick. They go broke because they can't find a job. We have 15 million people without a job, and imposing a mandate through health care is not the way to fix this economy.
We have a Department of Education, the federal department. I'm not sure why. The states used to cover education, but now we're spending $90 billion on education, no child left behind and all that. Should we cut that?
John, let me make this plain. We cannot cut education. We can't cut things that make America more competitive.
You're starting to have fun with this. One of the problems.
Oh, I'm loving this. One of the problems with the federal government trying to micromanage education is the same problem it has with everything that it tries to micromanage. It does not work. One of my guiding principles has always been, people closest to the problem are best suited to determine the solution to the problem, and that's a long way from Washington, D.C.
All right, that's K through 12 education. What about college? We're supporting college degrees, Pell Grants, Stafford loans, Perkins loans. Good thing?
Well, I think that one of the things that we have to do is to make sure that college is affordable for every young person in America.
I happen to believe that college is affordable for every young person in America if they do it the way many of us have done it. We work for it. We get extra jobs. There is a path to a good education if people look for that path.
Global warming, is it a big threat? Well, should I be scared?
Well, the threat from climate change is serious. It's urgent, and it is growing. Now, if we fail to meet it boldly, swiftly, and together, we risk consigning future generations to an irreversible catastrophe.
Catastrophe!
Climate change is not a crisis. Climate change does not stand up to the scrutiny of legitimate science. Climate change is something that has been happening since the beginning of this planet. I don't think it is a threat to the Earth. I don't think it's a threat to mankind. I believe that we should be responsible in terms of what we do with respect to the planet, but you can go overboard and try to do too much. I don't think this is a crisis. I believe we need to focus on other more important issues.
Thank you, Herman Cain, and President Obama, who is really actor Reggie Brown. And Reggie is not the president. Since you were last here doing these debates, you made some news yourself. You went to some Republican event in Louisiana, and they pulled you off the stage? What?
That's correct, John. Well, I was down there in New Orleans, and I was very excited to perform for the Republican Leadership Conference. I was taken off the stage, as you said, and they told me it was a time restraint.
Because you had gone too long.
Yeah.
Later, somebody said, no, it was racist. It was offensive what you said.
To call it racist is absolutely ridiculous. My material was not racist.
And the press jumped on you, but you then did, what, 80 interviews with various media?
Yeah. And they gave me a great chance to speak my side of the case. And it was, you know, I went there to have fun. I'm a comedian. I went there to do my job. I did it. And if they were uncomfortable, I'm sorry they felt that way. But I stand behind my my set and my material.
And they've stopped calling you a racist. So
yeah, they did.
That's good.
Because I'm not a racist.
Thank you, Reggie. Herman, please stay with us. The audience has questions for you next.
Wonderful.